instance methods, class methods, and static methods. What are they, how do they work, and when should I use them? This video was supported by Hostinger, who's having a Black Friday sale. Choose your favorite web hosting plan. Hostinger's premium shared hosting plan is only $199 a month, and that comes with a free domain, by the way. Click the link in the description and use coupon code MCODING in all caps at checkout to get up to 91% off all yearly plans. It's really easy to register your first free domain. And if you have multiple websites that you want to manage, it's easy to add them and keep track of them all in one place. If you've ever thought about making your own website, please consider using Hostinger. Instance methods, or just normal methods if you prefer, are supposed to operate on a specific instance of a class. When you call an instance method on an instance of a class, that instance, in this case A, gets passed as the first parameter to the method. This, of course, allows you to read from or modify that specific instance of the class. But sometimes when you write a method, you don't really care about the specific instance of a class, or maybe you don't have a specific instance yet. That's a good signal that what you're doing might be a good candidate for a class method or a static method. Here's a basic calendar class that just stores its events in a list. The addEvent method should just be a normal instance method, because different calendars can have different events. For scheduling purposes, it might be a good idea for my calendar to be able to tell if a certain date is a weekend or not. Whether something is a weekend doesn't really depend on any particular calendar, although it is related to calendars. All calendars better agree on whether or not a certain date is a weekend. Assuming, of course, we're ignoring people that live close to black holes. We acknowledge that this function doesn't care about any particular calendar instance by deleting the self parameter and marking it as a static method. Now we can call isWeekend on a date even without referring to a specific instance of a calendar. If we just happen to already be using an instance of a calendar, we can still use it this way though. Next, suppose I want to be able to read a calendar and construct one from a file. You definitely don't need an existing instance of a calendar in order to read one from a file. You just construct a calendar, do some stuff, read from the file, and then return the new calendar that you constructed. So you might think this should be a static method, and you could implement it that way, but it's actually a better fit for a class method. Notice here how we're referring to the class itself inside this method. The main problem with this is that it breaks inheritance. Here I have a work calendar that's inheriting from calendar. If I then try to call the fromJSON method from my work calendar, I would expect to get a work calendar out. But the fromJSON method had hard-coded a plain calendar, so it's going to return a plain calendar instead, probably not what you wanted. What I most likely want is to be able to refer to whatever class it is that happened to call this function so that I can create an instance of that class. Well, that's exactly what class method does. Class method inserts, as the first parameter of the function, the class that the method was called from. So if I use work calendar from JSON, then class will be work calendar. But if I just use a plain calendar from JSON, then it'll be a plain calendar. This is very similar to how a normal method works, except instead of inserting the instance, it inserts the class. Just like a static method though, you can call a class method from an instance of the class. Written this way, I think it can be a little bit confusing why you're calling something like this on an instance of the class when that instance is just ignored though. However, this can be useful if you want to call a class method or a static method from a regular one. It basically just saves you the inconvenience of having to call type on self. So that's the basic difference functionally. An instance method gets an implicit self parameter as its first argument, a static method doesn't get any implicit first argument, and a class method gets an implicit first argument of the class. By the way, the names self and class are just convention. You can call them whatever you want, that won't affect what actually gets passed to the function. An instance method will be passed the instance even if you name it class. So don't do this, just stick to convention and call it self. The only exception to that is for metaclasses, but metaclasses are weird in so many ways, so don't worry about it. So what are the typical usages of static methods and class methods? Static methods are actually pretty uncommon. Static methods generally don't use anything in the class or any instance of the class, so why are they in the class at all? Why put isWeekend inside of the calendar class instead of just making it a freestanding function? A lot of people would argue that it should just be a freestanding function. Get rid of static method altogether and just put it up here outside the class. In most cases, this is exactly what I would do. I wouldn't use a static method, I would just have a freestanding function. In a lot of cases, this would make even more sense than having it inside the class, because there could be other classes that might want to use this function. Something like a time zone class or a date time class might also want to know if something is a weekend. Why should this function be in the calendar class as opposed to one of those other two? But if the function really truly is somehow tied to the class itself, then you might want to use a static method. For instance, here's a matrix class with a can multiply method. It takes in two matrices and tells you whether or not their shapes are compatible in order to multiply them. You certainly could move it outside the class, but in that case, can multiply is just too general. It loses too much context if you move it outside the class. If it was outside the class, I would probably try to add something like matrices onto the end of it so that I know that it's associated with that class. The fact that I'm doing that, though, tells me that it's probably intrinsic enough to the class that it should just be part of the class. But even still, this matrix class is probably in a file called matrix.py. So maybe just that context is enough, and it doesn't need to be a static method. So you can see, this is why static methods are pretty uncommonly used. They're basically never needed, and when you do use them, the justification for doing so is shaky at best. Class methods, on the other hand, are extremely common to use. And searching for them in the standard library, we see that they're almost exclusively used for alternative constructors. This from JSON function actually was an example of an alternative constructor. They're usually called from, make, or create something. And their purpose is to just make an instance using a different set of arguments. Finally, how does static method and class method actually work? They're actually super simple to implement in Python because of the descriptor protocol. Here's basically the entire implementation. When you create a static method, it wraps some function. Then when you go to retrieve the static method in order to call it, it just ignores the instance and the class that it was called from, and it just returns the wrapped function. Technically, in Python 3.10, they made static methods callable, so you can call them even from outside a class. In this case, it just forwards the arguments to the wrapped function. And then here's the implementation of a class method. Again, it just wraps a function. And then when you go to get the class method, it binds the function to the owner, which is the class. A normal function would bind to the instance, so we just change that to the class instead. And the reason that I'm able to do this is because normal functions implement the descriptor protocol. Calling get on a normal function is how you bind the function to a specific instance. So in this case, we just use that built-in ability to bind to the class object instead of the normal instance object. And technically, the second argument is just ignored, but I do like to just put it in there anyway. That's all I've got. Thanks to my patrons and donors for supporting me. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you next time.